back to our channel, Grateful Geese Official. How are you today? Okay, I'm fine too, thank you. Before we start our lesson, please raise your hand and let's say basmala together. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, today we will still learn about data. But in this meeting, I will teach you about pictograms. So please watch this video until the end and don't forget to do your exercise.
Okay friends, today we will learn about pictograms. So please watch this video until the end. Pictograms is a graph that uses picture to represent quantities. A pictogram has a title and is labeled. A key is necessary to understand the information given. Now, how to make a pictogram? Okay friends, there are the steps to make a pictogram. The first step is you must pick your symbol. Pick a symbol or picture that accurately represents your data. The next step is assign a key. Sometimes the frequency of the data is too high. Then one symbol cannot represent one frequency. You must set a numerical value that one symbol will represent. And then the next step is draw the pictograms. Final step is drawing your pictograms. Draw the two columns that represent the category and the data. Now we will try to make a pictograms based on the data. The data is about the students has voted for their favorite ice cream flavor. The list below are the result. Chocolate has 8 votes, vanilla has 7 votes, chocolate chip has 13 votes, cookie dough has 8 votes, and the last flavor, strawberry, has 5 votes. Then we can start draw the pictograms. The first step, you must make a 2 column in the table. Don't forget to write the label and the title of pictograms based on the data. Look at the picture. This picture is table with the 2 columns. The first column, you can write the flavor of ice cream. There are chocolate, vanilla, chocolate chip, cookie dough, and strawberry. And then the second column is about number of votes. You can fill the column with the picture. And then don't forget to write the title. The title is about favorite ice cream. And then the next step, because the data is about ice cream, you can pick a symbol. You can use the picture of ice cream, and don't forget to make a scale. One ice cream is equal to 2 votes. Remember, one ice cream is equal to 2 votes. And then a half of ice cream picture, it means 1 vote. You must remember this key. Then the next step, we can start draw the pictograms based on the data. We can put the ice cream picture in the rows of chocolate at the first. From the data, we know chocolate has 8 votes. So we can draw one ice cream in here. One ice cream, it's mean 2 votes. And then we can add one ice cream again to be 4 votes, and we can add one ice cream again to be 6 votes, and the last we can add one ice cream again to be 8 foods. So from the picture, for ice cream, it means 8 foods. So chocolate has 8 foods. And then how about the vanilla? The vanilla has 7 foods. We can start draw in here. One ice cream, it means 2 foods. And then we can add one ice cream again to be 4 foods. We can add one ice cream again to be 6 foods. And we need one fourth again to be 7. So you must see the key. A half of ice cream, it means 1/4. So we can use a half of ice cream picture in here. So if you count, the vanilla has 7/4. Then how about the chocolate chip? From the data we know, chocolate chip has 13 folds. So we can draw the picture in here. One ice cream for 2 folds, and then we can add one ice cream again to be 4 folds, and we can add one ice cream again to be 6 folds, and we can add one ice cream again to be 8 folds. We can add one ice cream again to be 10 folds, and we can add one ice cream again to be 12. So we need 1/4 again. We can use a half ice cream picture in here to complete the pictograms like this. So if you count, the chocolate chip has 13 folds. And then how about the cookie dough? From the data we know, the cookie dough has 8 folds. So we can draw one ice cream in here for 2 folds. Then we can add one ice cream again to be 4 folds. And we can add one ice cream again to be 6 folds. And we can add one ice cream again to be 8 folds. So for ice cream represent 8 foods. And then how about the last flavor? We know strawberry has 5 foods. So we can draw one ice cream in here. It's meant 2 foods. And we can add one ice cream again to be 4 foods. And we need 1 food again to be 5. So we can use a half of ice cream picture to complete these pictograms. And then you can count, strawberry has 5 folds. So this is the pictograms based on the data. Friends, after you can draw the pictograms, this is the example of the question. We can answer it together. Number 1, what two flavors did the students like the least? From the pictograms we know, the answer is vanilla and strawberry. And then number 2, how many students vote for either cookie dough or strawberry? Okay, we can look at the pictograms. From the pictograms we know, cookie dough has 8 folds and strawberry has 5 folds. And then we can add all together, 8 plus 5. So we can get the answer is 13. And then the next question, number 3, how many more students vote for chocolate chip than vanilla? Okay, we can look at the pictograms. We know chocolate chip has 13 votes and vanilla has 7 votes. Okay, we can count 13 minus 7. So we can get the answer is 6. And then the last question, how many votes were there in all? Based on pictograms, we can add all together. 8 plus 7 plus 13 plus 8 plus 5, and we can get the answer is 41. Okay friends, this is the next example of the pictograms. The title is about apple salt. The first column is about the month, and the second column is about the number of apples. Okay, one picture of apple, it's equal 10 apples. And a half picture of apple, it's equal 5 apples. Now we will count the sales of apples from January until April. From the pictograms, we know in January there is only one picture of apple. So we can count 1 times 10. So the answer is 10. 10 apples in January. And then how about February? In February, there are 4 pictures of apples. So we can count 4 times 10. So the answer is 40. 40 apples in February. How about March? In March, there are 2 pictures of apples and a half picture of apple. So we can count in the bracket 2 times 10 plus in the bracket 1 times 5. So we can get the answer 20 plus 5. So the answer is 25 apples in March. And how about April? In April, there are 2 pictures of apples. So we can count 2 times 10. So we can get the answer is 20. 20 apples in April. So the pictograms is showing in January 10 apples were sold. In February 40 apples were sold. In March 25 apples were sold. And in April 20 apples were sold. The question is number 1, how many apples was sold from January to April? From the pictograms, we can add all together the number of apples in January until April. We can answer 10 plus 40 plus 25 plus 20. And then we can get the answer is 95 apples. Number 2, what is the difference between apples sold in February and March? We can look at the pictograms. In February, there are 40 apples sold, and in March, there are 25 apples sold. So we can answer 40 minus 25. So we can get the answer is 15 apples. The next question, in which month was the fewest apples sold? From the pictograms, we can see in January the fewest apples sold. And then the last question, in which month was the highest apple sold? We can see in the pictograms, in February, the highest apples sold. Okay, friends, maybe it's enough for today. Hopefully you are understand. And let's say hamdalah together. Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin. Don't forget to do your exercise and submit your answer to your teacher class. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.